Okay, cleaning the negative cable on a Holden Rodeo 1995, or known in the USA as a or North America as a isuzu pickup. So the negative cable just goes from here, negative post, along and just under this cluster of wires here. The positive, it's got the positive post, and this here is a battery gauge, and it's got a ground down there, and it runs along this cable and inside the cab. Again, I'm not a mechanic. I'm somebody that now has the spare time to look at the mechanical videos on YouTube. They're all much appreciated, and you know, I jot down something that I can do with my car every weekend. It's a weekend, and this weekend I'm going to clean the negative cable to the body. So I've got the car out on the weekend after going to work 5 days a week. I've checked that my belts are good. The oil is good amount of oil. I've checked my brake fluid, has enough brake fluid. Clutch has enough clutch hydraulic fluid. The radiator has got enough water. The power steering fluid is at the right height. This gauge isn't working at the moment, but I can usually check my fuel pressure gauge. While I'm driving, I'm constantly checking the volt gauge, as well as the, I got this on eBay, I can check and see if my alternator's charging my battery. I check my windscreen wiper fluid and a few other things, and alright, so I'll go to it. Okay, always work safe, use eye protection. I use skin protection now that it's available. It wasn't available in the 70s or 80s, but now that I can get these gloves, I always wear them. That's a negative lead. Positive. I'll now remove this bracket holding the battery. No doubt, you know, it'll be different for you to remove your battery. This is how you remove the battery on this truck. This is a heavy battery. It's a marine battery, and it's just fantastic. Never goes flat. You wouldn't want to leave your lights on for too long, but this is a highly recommended battery. This is an old truck. You know, if you get a bit of acid coming out of your battery, it can eat away this thing holding the battery. So what I do is I get a bit of engine oil and make sure it's got plenty there, and it seeps around and stops the acid. Okay, so it's a very good thing I'm doing this job this weekend. So the negative cable goes to there and grounds there on the battery holder. Then it continues on. You can see it goes around there, continues on, and the ground is that bolt just there. That's the engine ground. However, this lead here, when I wanted to see where it went, it actually snapped off something. So I'll have to find out where it goes and reconnect it. Okay, so it's the next day, Sunday. I've just been to the dentist, so hopefully I can make myself understood. When doing this work, never use a hydraulic jack. Never use a hydraulic jack always use a threaded jack to jack up your car. Use jack stands under your car and chock the rear wheels. Make sure the rear wheels can't move, or the front wheels if you've got the rear end of the car up. So that is to say that the opposite end of the car that's up off the ground, you need to chock the wheels, put your brakes on, make sure it won't move. Don't forget to put your handbrake on. So that's chocking the wheels with a stopper, preferably something like a brick, on either side. Give the car a bit of a shake sideways and forwards before you get under it. Don't test it if there's somebody underneath it. Do the test first. So test the car to make sure it won't fall. And then go around your car and make sure that all the work you've done to make sure that the car won't fall is still in place and sitting good. There was a young bloke just over there, and he died because his car fell on him. Okay, so that's the ground there, and I've drilled a hole on the chassis, and I'll mount it there. Okay, well, I'm very surprised to say that there's paint behind this ground on the battery holder. It looks very clean. The cable connection looks clean, but there's paint there. So I suppose that the design could be a little bit better. They've got this exposed cable with this ground attachment on it, and that's just completely exposed and open to blue rust, corrosion, that type of, you know. So I've cleaned up the connector of exposed metal. I'll put a bit of this marine grease or waterproof grease to stop any rust, and reattach it. You know, the paint could have been there for a reason to stop rust, but call me old fashioned, but I'd rather have metal on metal for a ground. Okay, so there's the engine ground, and I've got a swivel joint on that socket, and it's the first time I've used it in many years, and very good. Size 14, by the way. And there's the ground through there. Looks fairly clean. So I'll clean them both up with a bit of sandpaper and reinstall it. Okay, so the key points while it's on my mind to this job is if you're having a problem with the ground, it could likely be this area here where there's exposed cables, where there's a ground onto the battery holder. And this small third cable, don't go wrenching on it too hard. Find out where it goes carefully, and then take it from there. And that is the yellow and black cable.
There it is.
Okay, so this is a ground wire check on a 1995 Holden Rodeo or Isuzu pickup. 2.6 engine. The engine is RLJ. It's got TFB 5 SF. Okay, so that yellow and black grounding lead, I mounted that just down there, just behind the engine mounting bracket. So I'll try and get you a shot of that now. Just bear with me. Go under the car. And that's it there. So I'll just put a light coat of paint over that to help the rust, stop the rust, and that's just about it. Okay, so negative on first, and then positive. Okay, so just remember, don't do your bolts up too tight, or you'll strip the threads. Just try and get a handle on how big the nut is in relation to how much pressure you need to just snug the nut up. Okay, check over the car carefully, make sure your battery won't move, everything's done up, your posts are on, all your cables are connected. Give it a good check over, start her up, take it for a drive. Okay, so remember, very important, chock the wheels either side, opposite to the end that's lifted up off the ground. Use jack stands and do not use a hydraulic jack. Do not use a hydraulic jack. Use a threaded jack. A threaded jack is this type of system where it relies on a thread to push the car up and bring it down. If you use a hydraulic jack, you can swing something around behind you, knock the hydraulic release mechanism, and the car will fall on you and you can die.